Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video we are going to discuss ES6, the new features, the new keywords, the objects that have been implemented in ES6, then the features of JavaScript. So we will be discussing most of the points that are being introduced in ES6. So friends, let us start the discussion. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please click on the subscribe button so that you can get important updates whenever a new video is uploaded on the channel. So let us start the discussion. First thing, if we talk about ES6, it is basically governed by ECMS script. That is basically the specification standardized for all the scripting language, whether it is JavaScript, JScript, ActionScript. All the scripting language follow the specification given by the ECMS script. Now, if we talk about how to set up the environment for JavaScript, it's very simple. Any browser, or you can say every browser, supports JavaScript. So what you need to do, you just need to write the code and execute in the browser and it will start running. And if you talk about any framework or any runtime JavaScript, so you can go for node.js. So basically what node.js is, it is basically a JavaScript framework that is used to run create server as well as client side program. It is based upon non-blocking input output because everything in node.js is asynchronous, plus it has event looping. So all the features are provided by node.js. We can create a server application as well as client application. Now if we talk about the JavaScript, as you know, it is case sensitive. It ignores white spaces and new lines. Semicolon, it is optional. The new concept that is implemented is hosting, which allows JavaScript to use a component before it has been declared. Normally a component must be declared, then we can use it. But in hosting, the concept of hosting is we can use a variable before it has been declared. Now variable, before ES6, the variable was var and that was the global variable. But in ES6, a new variable is being defined that is called let. So let is basically used to define a variable the whose scope is within that block. So if we talk about global versus local, so if we are going to declare a variable using var, the scope of that variable is global. And if we are going to declare a variable using let, so let, the scope of that particular variable using let is within that particular block, whether that is a function or a particular if statement. So the scope of let is within that block. We have also const keyword through which we create constant variables. So constant, it's not a variable, it is a constant. So suppose we want to fix the value, so we go for const keyword. Now the other thing that is within JavaScript is functions. So basically what are functions? They are the building blocks and they can be reused in different programs. So if we want to reuse a particular module, we create a function for that. Function can return values. Now different types of functions are there. One is a function which doesn't return any value. Then we have parameterized function in which we pass parameter and based upon the parameter the function does some work and returns some value. Now if you talk about alert boxes, the boxes that are used to alert or give some message or ask the user for some input, so we go for alert boxes. So alert boxes are of three types. One is alert, simple alert, in which it will be showing a message. Then another is confirm, in which there will be OK and cancel. So if you click on OK, then only that value is being stored, and prompt is used for the user so that they can input any value. So it prompts the user to input any value. Then the other thing that is being introduced in ES6 is object. So this is using this object, you can create new object. And after that you can define different properties, different function. So the syntax is very simple, where, and then you just create the name of the object and equals to new object. This object class is used to create different types of object. You just need to instantiate this object and a new object will be created, and after that you can give the property, you can assign methods, you can assign arrays, anything you can do using this object. So friends, this was a discussion about ES6, all the important points that are being introduced, and few points are left, so that we will discuss in the next video. So friends, if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe, and thank you for watching this video.